Let's work a little bit with the vinyl cutting options. Those are options used with vector artwork like you see here to send to a vinyl cutter. One of the first things you might want to do after you design your logo or your graphic is go over here to the left and do wireframe to make sure there's no overlapping sections. You can see how the word S here and C, or the letter S and C, are overlapped. So we'll want to actually grab those, right click right on top of one of the lines and weld them together so that they don't cut that overlap in there. So make sure that all your overlaps are welded together. So that's now ready for cutting. So we're going to go up here to the top where the cut plot menu is and click on cut plot. It's going to ask you where your cutter is on this local computer. That's when it's attached to the computer you're using for your design. On a network or on an internet address. Normally it's connected to the printer you're using or the computer that you're using for the design. So we'll click OK on that. I'm going to expand this and make it larger so we can see it better. Basically what it's done is it's transferred that image to the cut plot menu, and this is basically showing you the width of the material that's in your printer or cutter, excuse me, and then where this is going to cut. So this is an exact representation of what's going to happen on your vinyl cutter. One of the things, normally it will show up like this lengthwise because normally letter is longer than it is wide. In this case we're using a 54 inch media, so I'm going to rotate this. And I think that'll fit on there because it was only 36 inches wide to begin with. Again, you can pick this up and move it. Wherever you place it on here, that's where it's going to cut on that vinyl. Generally speaking, the default setting right there is where it needs to go. There's four tabs across the top here. You've got a general tab, you've got a panel tab, options, and advanced tab. One of the things you might want to do on a vinyl cutter is use this small icon here called pole size. When you click on that, and I apologize, I don't have a cutter connected right now, but when you click on that, basically what it will do is it will send a signal to your cutter, and if your cutter is capable and if the communications is appropriate, it will actually then respond with a user defined, and then this number will change to the actual width that's available to you, whatever width that is, and that's determined by the where the pinch rollers are on the vinyl. So it's a good thing to kind of do that before you actually cut to make sure that you have plenty of width of vinyl for your cutting. Now if that's grayed out or if it doesn't work, it's generally not because of the program, it's because of the communication, whether the it's on a COM port or a USB or on the network, whatever the case may be. It just doesn't allow two-way communication with this in this case, okay? Something else is send now, send mode. This means that as soon as you hit the send button down here, it's actually going to send that file. But on that bottom where I hit send, that's going to actually send it to the cutter immediately. If you put on hold list, then it will actually hold in the cut queue. And that's what I'm going to do because I don't have a cutter connected. So I want you to see it in Production Manager when it shows up there. I just want you to see what it looks like. The position, this is actually interactive. You click that, and whenever you move this, the knife blade will follow this bottom right hand corner down here. So it actually shows you where it's going to cut on the vinyl, but interactively, live. This one is called Show Me. That actually shows you, it runs the vinyl cutter around that box on the outside to show you how much vinyl actually needs to be used for cutting that particular graphic. This is the size of the graphic. You can fit it to the media if you wish to. Just remember that when you change that, you'll need to change this back to 100% to make it equal to the original size. You can do multiple copies. You can put space between those copies. Again, down here, you could actually change the orientation if you think that's a better way to cut this without using as much vinyl. You can do a mirror. This is where you cut the graphic out and you're going to put it on the inside of the window so that people can read it from the outside, but you don't want the vinyl on the outside. You can do it that way if you want. All right, once you've got that set up, then what you'll probably want to do is go to the next tab. This is the panel tab. The panel tab is actually used, whatever's in this black box, that's what's going to cut. Generally speaking, if this is a really big image, it might actually divide it into panels. So if it was, you know, 2, 4, 5, 6 feet wide and you couldn't cut it all at one in one piece, it would panel it. The dotted lines are actually your overlap, and all that's controlled here in this particular menu. When you right click on a panel, that turns it off, so you could cut this one, readjust your cutter if you want to, and then turn that off and cut the next panel. Not a bad practice. Okay. Third one, let's just reset our panels, by the way. Click right here to reset the panel. Oh, and by the way, if you are weeding and you pull up, say, a couple of letters in the word bull up here or something like that, just shrink your panel down to that little piece, you know, something like that. And then what it's going to do is cut just those letters. Let me go back to the main screen. You'll see it cuts just those letters. So the panel can be used to adjust to cut just a part of the graphic if you need to. And don't forget right here, you can reset that. All right, third tab has to do with options for this particular graphic. And in this case, it's a weed border. I'm going to click that on, and basically what that does is it's going to cut the graphic and it's going to cut that red box around there. And this is the amount of space that's going to go around it. So that's the weed border for weeding. Some people use that. Horizontal weed lines. This is going to cut a line wherever it can between lines of text to make it easier to weed. You can also do horizontal or vertical weed lines. In this case, there's no place to put those lines without cutting through a letter. So guess what else we can do? We can actually do vertical split lines. In this case, it'll cut that line right up to the top of the N, then start it at the bottom of the N, go to the top of the horns, bottom of the horns down. So again, it makes it a little easier to weed this in sections. Now, if you don't like the placement of that, you can move that to whatever location you need to. All these are actually customizable, so you can place them wherever you want to, okay? Wherever you think is the best place to put this, right? So maybe something like that. You can also right-click on these and delete them, or right-click in here and add your own lines in here. So if you think you need a little room to between the horns there to kind of weed out before you get to the top, you can do that. So again, just right-click to delete, or right-click to add your own custom lines. And again, these are all repositionable. You can move these, right? That one is definitely okay because that's right in between the two lines. This one you could place wherever you need to get the most use out of this particular graphic. Sometimes you just need to move around till you get to the right spot, right? Okay, good. And then we can turn those on or off as needed. And then the last tab is actually an advanced tab, and this one you have to be very careful about. I would be very careful about changing anything in here. There's an auto weld. So for instance, if had we not welded the S and the C, it would have taken that and done it for us. But I like to do that in the design side rather than the cut side, because it gives me more verification that it was done correctly. I would turn on overcut, and you can probably just leave it in this setting. But basically what that does is that cuts, you know, the knife blade goes in, say, the top of the O here, cuts all the way around. And normally it would go to the exact spot where it went in, lift up and come out and go to the next letter. But that can sometimes leave behind a little bit of a nick or a nib or a tab. And when you're weeding, it just, you have to keep pulling on those. You can actually hear them snapping. If you do the overcut, it goes into the vinyl, cuts all the way around to the original location, and then just pass that in the same path by whatever amount you have in here. So that's very, very good. Now, a lot of these other features in this section here are covered in detail in the training DVD, but this is sort of a general overview of this. All right, so I'm going to hit send on that, and it's going to go to the hold list, and I'm going to hit done. I'm also going to change this just a bit. I'm going to take the Lone Star Cafe here and change that to a red. And what we're going to do is do more than one color. What happens then is when you go to your cut routine, okay, and it says okay on that, it's actually, you know, dividing it into the colors. This is the black part of the vinyl, and this is the red vinyl that you cut. So the black will cut, the red will cut, and then you put those two pieces together in the normal fashion that we do. Now, you can see, again, I would probably cut this with the weed board and all that and this one, but we have to position those together. So it would be a good idea to have some sort of registration marks in here to help you out. What I typically do is, and you can actually add those from the shapes list here. There's a registration marker right here if you wish to cut that. So what you literally could do is you could maybe put one here, another one up here perhaps, and another over here. Put as many as you want, it makes no difference, and you can resize those as much as you want as well. But when you click your graphic over here to cut, it will not only cut the black, but it cuts those registration marks, and it does the same thing for the red, right? So then what you do is you cut your black, and you be sure you weed around that registration mark. You cut your red, weed around that registration mark, and then you line up those registration marks, and that way your two colors will go in the appropriate place on your graphic. So if you need registration marks, they're built right into Flexi. And again, we find them over here in the shapes menu. It's that last icon, and these can all be resized to whatever size you think is appropriate. You know, just click on here and just resize it. So make it make it easy to see, so that you have plenty of room here to line things up. And that's a great way to do multicolors as well. So let me take this over. I'll send the black. Again, I'm going to put it on hold. So I'm going to send that, go to my red, send that, and I'm done. And let's go over and take a look at Production Manager now. Here's my Production Manager. And you can see in my hold queue down here, I have three jobs. I have my bull job, I have my other two colors over here. So I'm going to click it. Here's all the information. When I double click that, it actually shows me a preview of that graphic right here, so I can make some further adjustments if I need to. But that's a great thing to have, right? Again, here's my other job. Remember, that was just the black with the registration mark, the white with the registration mark, okay? At this point, since I'm in the actual queue right here, if I want to send that job, I could actually pick the job I want to cut, go right up here to the send button and send it. I can also right click on it and send it from here. So, you know, there's a lot of options for cutting, and you can see the preview here. Don't worry about how jagged that looks. That's just a preview to give you an idea of what's about to be cut on that particular graphic, and I think that's kind of great. See, it gives you a preview of what those look like, and that's a good thing. So when you're cutting, basic steps are, you know, you design your graphic, okay? You go to your cutter up here. You're going to choose the, you know, what size is your vinyl. Make sure you have plenty of size of vinyl in there. Make sure this is 100%. If it's anything less or more, each job, it goes back to the default. So you need to make sure you change that to 100 if you want it to be the full size. Decide whether you need to mirror it or not. Generally, I would go to the next tab here, Options, and turn on these horizontal or vertical weed lines. You can see in this case, I get my vertical lines, right? So I do those two things. And then I make sure that this overcut is on to make sure that it cuts easier, right? And then I just hit Send. Once I hit Send, it'll either start cutting immediately, as I said, if it's Send Now, but in this case, I put it on hold just to make sure I have everything lined up correctly, and I'm ready to actually send that job. I hope you enjoyed this. It's a very easy process to cut with Flexi. You're gonna need to practice that, so get some vinyl, practice it, and you'll be an expert in no time.